Good evening, YouTube. So I'm going to do a new thing. We're going to call it Wining with Dan. And basically, I'm going to drink wine and talk about crap. So it's not really any different than before, except for, I guess I'll show you the wine I'm drinking and something like that. This was full about an hour ago, but Meg and I made quick work of this bottle, but it's a Antinori, it's Toscana, it's really good. This is one of my favorite cheap wines. It's only like, I think it's about 15 bucks a bottle, so it's not too bad. It's, you know, it's not super cheap, but it's not really expensive, so perfect when you just need some wine. It's quite good. Highly recommend it. Yeah, so right off the bat, actually, I want to start on a positive note. So when I was in San Antonio for the FCA thing, first of all, had a great time. And after the event kind of wrapped up, I got to schmooze with some of the tech guys that work there, some of the, you know, service guys and actually some of the marketing people and stuff like that. And I have to say, that was really cool to be able to just schmooze with them, talk about stuff. We talked about some of the common problems with the Ferraris and talked about some of the, you know, certain models that have certain issues and, you know, dispel some of the myths about them. One of the guys actually owns a 348, which a lot of people seem to think is like one of the worst Ferraris to own, right? And it was funny because he was saying, yeah, once you take care of some of the common flaws with it, they're actually super reliable. So I had, you know, always heard the rumors that, oh, they're crap or whatever. And so that was interesting to hear someone who, you know, works on Ferraris a lot, saying, oh yeah, these things are actually really reliable. It was really good. The really fascinating thing was that they were talking about how 360s actually have a lot of problems. It's not because the cars themselves are necessarily unreliable. That's not what they're saying. The problem is, Ferrari made so many 360s and so many people bought 360s and they were so accessible that they kind of got abused. So a lot of these 360s that are out there, so if you're buying a 360, you gotta really do your homework and make sure that that thing is a solid car, because those are the ones that got, you know, really abused or sat around or treated really badly or didn't get the right service and things like that. And when those ones have problems, there's a couple of known things that can go wrong with the 360 that are extremely expensive, including like the heat exchanger. When that thing screws up, you can actually basically cause pressurized coolant to inject itself into your transmission or into your oil. Very bad. Really expensive. So you definitely don't want that to happen. Also, I got some pretty cool stickers from the marketing people there, so I don't know, I'm gonna have to find a good use for those, but anytime you can get that, it's pretty sweet. Could turn a laptop into a Ferrari laptop, or turn a regular piece of whatever crap into an awesome Ferrari piece of crap. So increases the value by like tenfold. It's pretty amazing. Just buy a sticker. It's kind of like, you know, Hondas and the VTEC, or the, you know, you add a sticker on it, it adds 5 horsepower. Ferrari sticker adds money. That's right. More wine. God, it's a good wine. So, I thought I'd tell you about all the cars that I've owned. Man, some bug or something. Alright, so I want to tell you about the cars that I've owned that are actually pretty cool. So, everyone, you know, well, if you haven't seen my really early video about garage talk, it's crap, don't watch it. If you didn't know, I'm actually kind of a muscle car guy. I started off with a love of muscle cars when I was 16. I bought a 1971 Chevy Nova for $2,000. Complete piece of shit. Yeah, absolute crap. Really rusted out. It was so bad that one time I hit a really big bump and the driver's side rear shock busted through the trunk. Yeah, I kid you not. And the whole car went and squat down probably 2-3 inches. And I had a, we had to jack the car up, pound down the shock with a hammer, and weld in place some new sheet metal so it wouldn't fall through again. Which, trying to weld metal to rust, it's very difficult. Words to wise. Yeah, and it also eventually had some sort of oil pump problem, and it wasn't pushing any oil up to the lifters. Yeah, that was really good. Like, you could pull off the valve cover while it was running, and you wouldn't get any oil on you. It was not good. Wine. So, after I got rid of the Nova, I bought a 1971 Cutlass. It was actually pretty nice. I think I paid $6,500. That was quite a while ago. It was in the 90s. And it had a 455, ran really solid. Didn't ever really have many problems with it. Took it to a drag strip a few times. I think it ran in the 14s or something like that. It wasn't exactly all that fast, but I thought it was the fastest thing ever. Oh, yeah. So it was pretty, though. It actually looked very nice. And believe it or not, that was the car that I met Megan with. And then after I got rid of that one, I took a little break from muscle cars and then eventually got a 1970 Chevelle, not an SS, just a regular Chevelle, but it had a 468, total drag car, big tires in the rear, skinnies up front, full roll cage, drag buckets, 5-point harnesses, a spool in the rear, 14-to-1 compression. Starting that thing was a absolute nightmare. And then when you'd back out, you know, because it had a spool, it'd go and squeal. It was pretty insane. It was very fast. I didn't really get a whole lot of track time with it, and the few times I ran, I hadn't quite dialed it in, so I think I was running 12s or something like that. And I'm pretty sure it could have ran 11s, but that thing was badass. Oh, and I had a 5,000 or 5,500 stall torque converter on it, so when you'd stomp on it, it would flash up to 5,000, and it was bad as hell. That thing was awesome. After the Chevelle, I actually got into my little Mustang thing. That's when I bought my first Mustang, a 98 Cobra. Eventually, I threw a Vortex supercharger on it, tracked the crap out of that car, took it to the drag strip. We were taking that thing to the drag strip almost every week. Took to the road courses. Got a great story about how I went to Gingerman Raceway with it and got black flagged. And when I pulled in and asked why I got black flagged, they said, "Oh yeah, your rotors are glowing bright red." That was good. And my rotors ended up cracking, so we had to change out my rotors while at the racetrack. We drove to a parts store in another car, picked up some rotors, came back, swapped them out, put it back out on the track, cracked those rotors too. Fuck yeah. So, 4 front rotors in one day. That was a pretty expensive day. And then after that, I had a Subaru STI. I think it was a 2006, something like that. Really fun car, perfect for Michigan with the winters, you know, the all-wheel drive, put on some snow tires, and holy crap, like, those things in the snow are a blast. Let me tell you, absolute fun. If you're in a snowy area, totally should consider an STI. It's absolute fun. So that brings us to about when I moved to Texas. That's when I bought my 04 Cobra, which you've seen the story on that. And if you haven't, you should go watch that story. It's the 04 Cobra death, so I'm not going to talk about that car. And then after that, I got a 2008 Mustang GT, bright red, really pretty. Didn't ever really do anything to it. Sold it shortly after that. Took a break from cars, and that's when, after that, I bought my 2013 STI hatchback. Pretty cool car. Enjoyed it for quite a while. Had some fun with it. But I just missed big V8s with all the torque and all that goodness, and that's when I decided it was time to go for the Ferrari. So there you go, from an STI to a Ferrari. It's quite an interesting change, but absolutely worth it. More wine. Yes, good stuff. So there you have it. That's all the cars I've owned. We've owned some, you know, obviously lots of normal cars. Like, we've had two Mini Coopers, two Ford Focuses, we're calling it the Ferrari Forester, but it's the Subaru Forester. Had Saturn Astra, a Saturn SC2. I've had a Dodge Dakota pickup truck. That thing was actually pretty badass. Had a lot of fun with that. A couple other cars I can't think of right now, but lots of cars, some pretty badass ones, lots of fun. All right, well, it's gonna be a busy week. Got a lot of work to do, like, you know, money making work, not this YouTube bullshit. So gonna have to go do some more of that. Got some emails from my boss. Something blew up, of course. God, it's always shit going wrong. Well, I'm gonna drink some wine. You guys should probably too. Well, if it's Wine 30, wherever you are, subscribe, watch that video, give me a thumbs up, drink some wine, hit thumbs up, share, wine. We'll do some more car stuff. It'll be sweet. We'll see you around.